You give us 3 minutes, and we give you the world. Good evening. I'm Casey Wong. A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head of OCP, Omni Consumer Products, that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer, and that cancer is crime. It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me! Shut up!
I'm sorry. There seems to be a
disturbance? I'm a big fan. Now move! Don't adjust your television sets. Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly. Now, this message goes out to the new guy in town. It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of nuke in old Detroit. The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of. Let's get you up here. We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of nuke. Oh man, you're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy. New guy, us Torchheads are more than capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder? We do it all. You've got the money. We've got the power. So let's talk.
Good to see you, Murphy. Lieutenant's at the main entrance to the TV station.
How do all, and welcome back to Immersion Gaming. And to his first episode of Robocop Rogue City. And as you can see, it looks fan-bloody-tastic! And so it should, because it's on maximum settings. It's on, everything's on epic. 4K. Ray tracing's on. Everything's on. This is how Unreal Engine's supposed to look. Not how Fort Solace looked. With all that crap and all them stupid textures we're getting on surfaces and stuff like that, because they've taken half of frigging things out of Unreal Engine that's needed, like looming and stuff like that. But yeah, how good it looks. I don't think the character models are fantastic in this, but again, this in made by a huge company. You know, it's the company that made it is Teyon, I think they're called, the developers. They're not a massive developer. So, I won't expect it to be like Rockstar, quite out of quality, you know what I mean? Like GTA or something like that. But, like I said, most games that are made in Unreal Engine 5, they've already got something going for them because Unreal Engine 5 is amazing. And this looks amazing. Sounds ace, that Aaron in war. That iconic walk from films.
The ground's shaking. Judgment Day is here.
No, it's only me. You're all right, mate. Oh, that's ray traced reflections. That's all proper reflections. Because ray tracing means, for those of you that don't know, that it there's actual ray tracing cores in the graphics cards that I've got. And they deal with like light reflections and actual, they trace the light, that's why it's called ray tracing. It traces the light from the source to, so if it's a light bulb say, to wherever the light's reflecting off and things like that. So, and obviously each different surface has a different reflective, I don't know the word for it, a different reflective makeup as such, you know, so obviously glass and water and stuff like that, it's like a mirror like that. But then when you look at say this van here, as you can still see everything, but it's like more mushed in it, because it's not perfectly shiny like a mirror would be. So that's basically, when I'm saying ray tracing, that's what I mean. It's also ray trace shadows and stuff, so shadows are accurate and that as well. But it just adds so much more to a game. But like I said, it's a lot, it takes a lot to run it. So that's why a lot of people turn it off, because it lowers the
hey, handsome, we're
frame
here for
rate.
The show. Go get him, Robo.
Move along, ladies, or there will be trouble.
Yeah, it looks amazing, that. Looks really good, it does, don't it? Looks really good. Really good, it does. You want beard. I'm so glad that it's Peter Weller as well that's done the voice for it, and he's let him use the original face from. Is that one of them cars? Oh no, them cars are in it. Remember them cars out that the criminals stole, like top end cars. Can't remember the name of it. It was some at 5,000 or something, I think. I'll show you one when I see it. Hey there, Kojak. How's it going? But yeah, I'm impressed. Looks good. Stop running bad here, but to say I've got it on 4K, maxed out, everything on Epic.
They came out of the trucks and they just started shooting at anything that moved.
I can see your lady is still quite shaken up. I'll get one of the paramedics to check on her.
Oh, don't bother. She's only jonesing.
Yeah, I aren't even using the frame generation either. You know, where I was telling you about in Fort Solace. I tried it again in this, with the frame generation, where AI puts an extra frame in between all proper frames. And it's giving me cutting, screen cutting. So I've just turned it off. I'm not even going to bother with it. I'm probably not giving it long enough for it to learn or whatever it needs to do, but I haven't bothered with it. It runs okay without it, so I don't need to.
I wouldn't bother. I already ran the plates.
You should know by now, when it comes to evidence, we're hoarders.
When it comes to evidence, we're hoarders.
Right. I can hear the cat. Hey, puss. Push. Get them before they get you. That's same. Anyway, yeah, I've noticed from what I've heard as well, it is a bit glitchy. Again, though, it's not a big company, is it? So, but yeah, that's what I'm going to say, this van here, that's the same sort of van that they used in Robocop 1, where it rammed into that frigging toxic waste thing, wasn't it? When it went, "Mountain, help me." It was the same, it was one of them vans.
If it keeps on like this, we're gonna run short of body bags.
Run short of bodies? Like he's a goner. Another one getting CPR over there.
I'm going to give you 10 milligrams of diazepam to make you comfortable.
Can I have 10 milligrams of diazepam, please?
Make it double.
Make it double. Mother's little helpers, little blueies. So this is that Channel News thing that we're just seeing him on, that punk.
We can't wait any longer. Those trigger happy maniacs have a ton of hostages. But sir, Roger that. Over and out.
What is the situation?
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on the way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is going to clean up this place?
Lewis.
I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side.
Let's get a move on, Lewis.
Medic?
We have criminals to apprehend.
There you are, partner.
Lewis.
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Hey, you can't go in yet. We need to wait for the reinforcements.
Oh,
reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
Go on, Robo.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me, but you can take the heat. Go, I'll figure something out. Besides, you could do with a head start. Go on.
He's a bit sharp of himself, isn't he?
I've got a signet ring. How much do you think I can get for it?
Is it gold?
It was taken off someone famous. Just look at him. He looks kind of familiar.
There he is. The man.
Guys! We've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Yeah.
Drop it, scum.
Quartet
Dead or alive, you're coming with me. Getting where his foot is.
Oh, I love yoga.
Yeah, I'm one of them in mouth. Punk.
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
Use LT to Robocop vision to investigate individual objects. Yeah, I have been doing that, haven't I? Iconic song though. Well, not song, but tune. Fake ID, thank you. Oh, you gotta collect crime evidence.
Nuke.
What does it mean by, how do I actually scan things to find out more about them then? That's what it said, didn't it? I'll have to figure it out. I'll have to figure it out as we go along.
Your move, punk.
Oh! Don't fucking grenade here, you little twat! I like how everything's destructible as well. I like the walls and that there, look. Oh, what was that? Oh, someone just come in. Oh! Right, I'm done with you. Fuck off! One of them! bastard. And you. You.
He took my freaking hand off!
Warning. All personnel, evacuate immediately.
That's not a very reassuring voice, is it?
Warning. All personnel, leave immediately.
Immediately.
How about now?
Warning. All personnel, evacuate immediately.
I can't even do what else now? I can't fire a gun.
Warning.
Here we go!
There she is.
Worried about the weight limit?
Lois, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a key card from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After
a
you.
A bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
They sabotage the elevators and staircase too. They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
Deal with the case for criminals, though, love. Can't we dodge a roll then? Not dodge, crouch. No.
That graffiti is fresh.
I bet some of those idiots are still here.
Press B to heal. I know, I'm not already. And that's what you heal yourself with, them blow things. What's that? So how do you scan things? You can, does it? Whoa, what's this?
Oh shit, it's Robocop! It's that metal freak!
Any more tricks up your sleeve?
I will keep them coming.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
Lois, you might want to get behind him, you know, seeing as though he's bulletproof and made of metal.
My hand! Kill the freak!
Bomber, I give him my hand, will ya? Two we won. Hey! Don't see them sort of skills every day, do you? One bullet went straight through him. Through his eyeball. Came the back of his head and went through the other one's right nostril.
This is how we do it.
Hey.
Gender reorientation completed.
Not picking any weapons up.
Robot uses his robot gun.
Simple as.
Nuke. And what happened here?
Cause of death, nuke overdose. I'm guessing they did that to him then.
Well, don't shoot at the fucking robot when it's coming towards you then, you prick. You deserve it. Okay, if Robocop came walking to me like that, no matter what I'd done, it'd be like, no. Fuck that, he's bulletproof anyway, so what's the point? He's just gonna blow me a new fucking asshole.
Your move, creep.
Blow his head off. Oh, ho, ho! Well, half of his head off. Come up just above his ear. Nice.
Yummy.
It's all over the wall, look. Whoa. Fucking hell, destroyed him. What happened to him, man? The crowd just got a lot smaller. Is that discriminating documents or incriminating documents? Stolen wallet?
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
You know you're gonna get Robocop catchphrases all the way through, don't you? From me and him.
Whoa, what was that?
Nice shooting, Lewis.
How can I pull him back? Whoa, what are you doing? Sausage! Must be a way to throw them back. Otherwise, why would it show you that they're there? Fuck off. Lewis, why don't you just stand up right in front of me while I'm shooting? That's a good idea, isn't it? Gotta do, test your bulletproof vest. Hey, look. How do you do it? You must be able to throw them back. Oh, he's got a helmet on. No, he's not, yeah. In a bit. In a bizzle, me shizzle. No guns now, we must be on to it next.
It's that service box, isn't it? Hey, why don't you check it out?
Why don't I, Lewis?
You can use Robocop vision to investigate objects or people to find clues. Investigable objects are marked with question mark. Press LT while looking. We already know this. Wait, we already done it already.
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
I think I've got something just for that.
Chewing gum.
Nice work, Lewis.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
In blue finally decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
Murphy?
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick, before they kill anyone else.
Is that how he sees himself?
I know that look, Murphy.
It's still as
you
Murphy.
Saw something, didn't you?
Oh, he's having a flashback.
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
Bless her.
Slime bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back. Scumbag!
Scumbag! Why has he got pictures of New York, but in Detroit? You're not allowed to have pictures of other towns when you're in a town. You can only have pictures of that town, not other towns. Or cities. Crap. Hey, did you not say you need a new monitor, Lewis? Got you a new monitor. Boom! This stolen handbag. Oh, Bonnie broke the sofa. That's shit texture, that really, isn't it? But sponge. To say it's in Unreal Engine 5. I suppose they didn't really want to put as much detail into breakables, though, right? It's not, like, imperative, is it? Crime evidence. Can I throw them back? No, I can't. There must be ways to throw them grenades back. Yeah, just blow your own mates out with grenades, why don't you, you fucking dialogues? What's old Nancy McNoodle doing? Doesn't Detroit look beautiful tonight, Lewis? Oh! Get Clara all over the wall, my brains. Who's shooting her? Fuck off with grenades, man! Can I have some grenades, like?
Shit.
Where is Kane? Where is Kane?
Coming with me.
New lifetime supply of new. Cannot get it in my neck. It is made of metal. Keeps bending the needle.
Wow. Would you look at the mess you've made? Get out of here, you dirty animal! Antidepressant. You can tell it's based in 90s, look at all tellies. Oh. Wait, see if it's early 90s or late 80s. Because Robocop 1, the film, were based in, were made in 87. But then Robocop 2, I think that might have been early 90s when that came out. A couple of years after or something. Punk flower.
Watch out! He's coming! Kill the hostages!
I dare you. I fucking dare you. I'll blow your right bollock off. Knock. Excuse me, room service. When you face criminals who have taken hostages, you have to only a few seconds to eliminate the threat. to protect the innocent. Use your extremely, your extraordinary reflexes to meet this challenge. Okay?
Breach!
Boom! Did they kill hostages? No.
Thank God you've come! This lady really needs to see a doctor!
You think?
Murphy, these people need help. Why don't you go ahead? I'll stay with them.
Right.
Why is he walking like he's shot his kecks?
We have rescued three hostages. One with a gunshot wound to the abdomen. Requesting urgent medical assistance. Over.
Get out! Get off! Get off! I don't want any of what you're doing. I'm pressing off. I thought I had night vision on this. Guess not. Ah, that's it. Fraggle.
Let's show him!
I can't believe you can't pick them friggin'. There must be a way to pick them grenades up when they throw them at you if you're quick enough. Damn. Whoa! Dropped him like a sack of spuds. What happened to you, sweetheart? Are you okay? Show me. Show me. What are you going to show me? How to be a human target. I'm one of them in my. Got a bit handy with them frigging. Let me try my other gun. Shotgun, I think. This will be better for close combat, won't it? Clamp more grips. Clamp more grips on his frigging bollocks, I'll soon shoot up. Oh. don't like using anything but his gun though, because Robocop doesn't really use any other guns, does he? He just uses his gun. That's in his leg. Oh, look what we've got there. Hello? Oh, you little bastards. Now that's how you clear a room. We haven't seen Note yet though, wait till we've seen like Ed 209s and that.
You have 10 seconds to comply.
Like I said in trailer video as well, I don't know if Robocop 2, the robot, he's just a statue in this, or if he actually moves and you get to fight him and stuff. That'd be pretty cool if you get to fight him. Him beast of a robot, that. But I don't see how you would, because they killed him, didn't they? They killed him at the end of Robocop 2. Pulled his brain and freaking spine out. Is that the only way to kill it? Because it was just freaking bomb proof and lot, wasn't it? Dropped it on top of the building and lot. Shot the freaking grenade while it was still in his hand. I'll teach you to play with grenades, won't it, you little knob jockey? Oh, what's going on here? Who's shooting? Will you fuck off? I tell you what it is. Fuck off, prick. Come on, Robo! Ow.
Breathe, bonk.
Green screen! Wake up and shine. Interview with Jerry Jenkins. Another sweet. Oh, is it that sunblock? Is that career money and new sunblock commercial? Is that frigging sunblock, isn't that the word that they did advert for where it was blue? You end up looking like a smurf when you put it on. Guys, this is a cooking show.
Lewis, where are you?
Make sure we're not missing out any goodies. Because I think you have to upgrade yourself on this. That's what you're collecting them that crime from that for. That evidence and stuff. Need to upgrade him. Thank you, kind sir. Editing room, that. Where they edit the videos. I could do a video editing job now. Everything I've learned since I've been started doing this channel, I could definitely do a video editing for people. Whoa, you fucking tosswank, what was that? Oh, she's only smashed his frigging eye ocks.
Darling, could you get the napkins from the cupboard?
Oh, he's not having frigging hallucinations, is he?
Sure thing, Mom. What are we having? Surprise.
What happened?
Little man, have you washed your hands?
What blew up?
Do I really have to? I wasn't playing in the dirt. Of course you do. No more discussion. Darn. What about Dad? Is he gonna be back for dinner?
As your mother says, son, Daddy's busy. Pulling my mechanical pisser.
Bananas and Coke, what more could you ask for? Balanced nutritious diet, bananas and Coca-Cola. I don't like this at all. I've got a feeling something's gonna freaking happen.
Alex?
Huh?
What do you think about the color of this dress? I'm not sure if I like the pattern.
Wish it had stopped flicking like that. It's making me jump.
James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer just like his dad.
That's great, love, but I'm a bit busy at the moment, if you hadn't noticed. Friggin' eyeballs hanging out. Can hear me heartbeat, which is never a good sign. Get out of here.
Get out of here! Do nuke. Big King.
We cannot let him pass!
Oh, here we go.
It's your fault they'll die!
Time to die!
Come on! Will you? What the fuck? I can't even see. What? Will you piss off? Fucking show him, we'll look sick. 20 minutes to reload your bastard gun, you fucking sausage jockey.
Kill that freak!
Fucking hell. They're all survived, I think, anyway. That one's just lucky, that, though.
Moves, cop! I'm not dying here! Get
what
me
want?
Another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
No, I'm not.
You work so hard, honey. Why
oh,
don't you take
shit.
Some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey, wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost
you.
You
you're dead, so...
You've got 3 seconds! Three!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
Two! Are you fucking deaf?
Promise me, we will stay like this forever.
One! Last chance, weirdo!
I love you so much, Lewis.
Lewis.
You okay there, Murphy?
I seem to be having problems.
Lewis.
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can't you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
Poor Robo. Don't treat him like he's a fucking freak, don't they? But he's still part of the human. The most important part, his brain, is the human bit. And his heart and that as well, I think. There's a lot of internal organs they kept. There we are, back at precinct. Come see Chief. There he is.
I can pay my bail now. Cash? No problem. Do you take singles?
Get back in line.
They're here.
Robo!
Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right, all right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as Robocop.
They're picking out one.
We asked Max.
He's just killed a full frigging building full of them.
At OCP.
Now quiet.
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen. I would trust this guy with my kids.
If
I had any. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out. You, follow me.
I used to hate that in the film, how they just treat him like merchandise.
Everyone is dismissed. And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
Oh, these are cops that have been killed then. Motor City is the first city where the police are owned by a private corporation, OCP. A mega corporation, you know, if that ever happened, where police are controlled by, so they're basically, you know, privatised. So companies, rich companies like that can become our frigging security services. That'd be it, we'd be fucked. Healthcare, rehabilitation, military and data storage and transfer says that they will not stop there. They are interested in taking over the police of other metropolises. I bet they are, yeah? Metropolises. Because then the people that work for them companies as well would be immune to everything. They get away with all if they controlled the police. That's why you can't do that. It has to be the police force and the like, hospitals and things like have to be controlled by the state. They just have to be. I mean, that's not much better, but it's better than letting frigging companies do it. They're interested in taking over the police, including Baltimore and Chicago. What do they have to offer? Excellent management and access of the latest technology. Will this convince more authorities to put their law enforcement forces in private hands? No. Fuck it, that's ridiculous if that's even put forward. It's bad enough for privatising the things we have privatised. Like a rail network and stuff like that. And bus services and stuff. Better hurry up and fix that visor. They don't like having that smashed there on screen. Someone just shouted me. Who shouted me? Someone shouted, Murphy, can you give me an hand? Well, hello there, sweet cheeks. Figging out. Look at typewriter, that's when typewriters went electronic in the 90s. Late 80s, early 90s. Didn't last long though because computers came out then, so there were no need for them. Friggin' hell, yeah, and when computers were connected to modems through your phone line and that. Fuck me, how slow it was. What's this? Type of incident, missing body. Person reporting, Nancy Maguire. Officer found the report, Michael Briggs. Description of event. Miss Maguire's husband's body has gone missing during transport to Hawthorne's funeral home. Moreover, there is no information on such a delivery in the funeral home's records. Additional comments. It's a third report on a missing cadaver this week. We need to look into it. What are we doing with dead bodies like? Probably one of... First place you had to be searching is local Chinese, caught Indian, extra meat. Hope for a bit of cheap meat. Well, hello there, Estevez.
I can deal with blood, guts, but puke is a no-go for me. I'll be a sport and move his ass to the drunk tank for me. You've got your special gloves and extra protection, so you shouldn't mind.
Move it, Pong.
Just take him downstairs. I owe you one, Murphy. Oh no, the smell is following you. I'm gonna be sick.
Well, it's gonna follow me, innit, you silly woman? He's on my freaking shoulders. What? I just drop him down middle.
I don't remember getting on a roller coaster.
Go to sleep, my little child. Rest your sleepy head. Shooting range. That's where the first saw his gun, wasn't it? When they just heard that. Not rest of them, we just shoot in that.
Look who's back home. Just toss him in one of the empty cells.
Toss him in, yeah. Oh yeah, this was before that. Before there were frigging body cams and stuff on it. Police could do what they want back in them days, and they did.
Ah, finally home.
Home, sleep sweet tight. Home.
Robo Pig, why do you have to spoil our fun all the time? You metal freak.
I'm the freak. You're wearing Rupert the Bear pants with a dog collar on with a padlock on it. A squirrel's testicles hanging on your other necklace. And a leather jacket that's been graffitied. And you're calling me a freak. Okay then, Jasper. Here we go. Oh, come on. Oh, will you come on, robot fucking hell? Every single one. Oh yeah, great, look how fast they're moving. Go fuck yourself. I only missed two though, out of all of them. I love that being filmed though, where they're all shooting rays like that, doing what they're doing there, just single shots. And then you can just hear... And they're all looking down at the down friggin'
Hi, Murphy.
Aisles. Hey, dude. This where they can plug his spike out of his hand into computer to get, like, access files and stuff. Ah, that's it there, look. See that hole there? He's got, like, a spike in his hand. And he's, like, when he does a fist, it comes out of his knuckles. And you can just push it in, and that's how he accesses his... So look through police records and stuff like that. This garage. Love the hair, dude. Big ball. Double barrel, big ball. Seeing if there's all like to collect, because I'm sure we'll be upgrading soon. So if I can get any extra goodies that I do. That's our car. The one with the extra stiff springs to cater for his fat ass. I think that's it. Hey there, cheesy tits. It's a communications hub, I think.
Let me,
Hey there, Lewis. How you doing?
What's this place? That's where. There, look, there's your ray tracing. Well, your ray trace reflections, anyway. Yeah, probably not best thing for a robot to be getting a shower, I don't think.
God damn it, when will this be fixed?
Don't hold your breath. OCP isn't looking to spend a dime on our equipment.
Excuse me, Ramirez. Do you mind?
What seems to be the problem?
My damn locker won't open. Can you try?
Can you try? He could probably flick it and door and fly off its hinges.
Wait, what is all this shit doing in my locker?
We wanted you to be safe out there.
Yeah, you guys, very fun.
Very good use of police time. She's Robo's area. Remember it from films? What were we saying, Doc? What's up, Doc? It's looking a bit threadbare, isn't it? Anyhow, could do with sprucing up a bit.
There's my favorite walking, talking law enforcement machine.
Fuck off.
Okay, let's get on with it.
OCP. Robocop program. The program's main purpose is to produce an advanced 24-hour mechanical police officer, a hybrid of cybernetic technology and a human brain. The element that sets up the program apart from the others is the human donor, an experienced police officer whose abilities and professional experience will be integrated into the machine's onboard computer. All that is made possible through the use of the donor's brain. Details, division, security concepts. Director, Bob Morton. Unit name, OCP Crime Prevention Unit 001-Robocop. Human donor, Alex Murphy. Just imagine that though, so you wake up and you now, BS being a robot, like being bulletproof and powerful and all that shit, but to then be owned by a company, so to be stock basically, that they could turn you off whenever they wanted, sort of thing. That's the part of it I couldn't handle, because you're still alive in essence, as far as you're aware, because your brain's still alive, so you shouldn't belong to anybody. Since OCP owns Detroit's police and OCP, like any successful corporation, is profit-driven, the work of all police officers must become cost-effective. To educate you and your subordinates on how to fulfill your duties at the lowest possible cost. See, this is the problem when you privatise it. We have prepared a brochure entitled, Is It Worth Intervening? Oh my God. We oblige you to hand it to the officers of Metro West. So, rather than spending all money, even more money, just turn a blind eye to certain crimes. Already then, and then they wonder why Detroit's in such a mess.
Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar.
I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
Here we go. Where we'll get to see Alex Murphy.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance.
Fucking hell, man.
Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
Doesn't it hurt him?
Hurt? Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So better be on your best behavior.
So that's what we were taught grade and stuff, I bet, then. We get points.
The chip is in. Let's see what we have here.
Yeah. All main objectives completed. And they're saying that the one pleased with his... All hostage, so I can't. Some hostages must have got killed then. All hostage studios save. Pieces of crime collected, 500 XP. So we got all crime evidence anyway. But I didn't see any hostage killed, but it must have done if he's saying that. B. Behave! Each time you achieve a new level, you receive a skill point that can be used to develop your skills. Developing skills allows you to increase efficiency, obtain unique parts, and unlock favourable dialogue options. Does it now? Well, that sounds fantastic. And we've got three points we've got to spend, yeah. So let's have a look then. What's this? Combat. Bonus weapon damage. Armor. So it's reduces damage taken. Vitality. You can use fuse box to recover up to 50% of your health. Increase the maximum number of OCP recovery charges to 4. So that should be quite handy. Dash allows you to ram into enemies or quickly escape danger. Yeah, that'd be good. Dash. Should we dash away from friggin' grenades as well. Focus. Your reflexes allow you to see your environment in slow motion for a short time. That'd be handy as well. Ricochet. That was you hit enemies behind cover by bouncing bullets off certain spots. Activate Robocop vision to use. He does that in filmed anywhere. That guy's taking baby hostage or something like that. I can't remember. In place where they were making nuke. And he bounced bullet off at frigging freezer door. One of them big freezers that they have in like restaurants and that. Let's you hit enemies behind. I've seen that. Scanning lets you more often detect helpful information such as safe combinations or discover hidden objects or rooms. That could be handy for earning more points, which would allow us to upgrade other things. This doubles earned public trust points. Public trust points. Is that these points that we gain? Lower requirements for all dialogue options. Yeah, we'll definitely go for that. And then if it means we're earning more points, then yeah, for definite. Hamper detects information. Yeah, we'll go for that as well then. Save.
Well, I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order.
to be sure.
What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor...
Oh, here we go.
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma? Might as well talk to the microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
Well, you
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work. However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side.
Yeah, exactly.
Your brain.
Your mind.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
You heard what he said, Dr. Blanche. He's needed elsewhere.
Well, can't say we didn't try. Everyone get back to whatever the fuck you usually do around here.
Can I punch him? Can I just break his neck and just have done with it and then he's gone and we can just get on with his police work then? Oh, he's got a robot arm. We're practically brother and sister. Sort that out. It's fucking annoying, man.
Man, I tell you, it was crazy in that TV station.
Good job you had Murphy in with you.
You bet. Without him, we'd all be goners.
Smoking in PlayStation. Fucking mental times on it in the 80s and 90s. Just so free, you could just do what you wanted. You know, you could just live the life you wanted, and if you wanted to smoke, you'd smoke. People didn't have to stand right next to you. They didn't like it. Why has he stood with no top on but with his helmet still on? It's like one of frigging village people. Young man!
Murphy! Could you please help me out here?
Oh my god, does any of you do your frigging jobs? Well, you don't look like a criminal at all. I'm sure I didn't just see your face on that poster over there. Yeah, that's definitely not him, is it? Anthony Harris. $2,000 reward. Oh, hello there. You're lucky I ain't got a ding-a-ling anymore. What is it? Sausage. What do you want? What? Can't handle a few people.
What seems to be the problem, officer?
Reed is in the briefing room, and I have my hands full. There are so many complaints filing in that I can't keep up. It's getting crazy in here. Could you open up another line and help me?
I am here to serve the public trust.
Take the spot on the podium. You're a lifesaver, Robo.
This line is open. Please form an orderly queue.
Officer, John. I have a problem. My neighbors are hostile toward me. I think it's because they're jealous of my new dog. Why would they get so worked up every time I take him for a walk?
What is his name?
He has a beautiful red coat, so I call him Fire. He likes to hide, so sometimes I have to yell, Fire! Fire! To find him. Anyway, can you do something about my neighbors?
You disrupt public order. Issue a warning.
Yeah, no, but I will let you off with a warning.
That's fine. I don't mind paying the price for having the cutest dog in all of Detroit.
Next, please.
I got something for you, officer. I know where you can find a wanted criminal. That poster over there says there's a reward for that information. And I want it.
I want details.
Are you blind? I'm the guy from that poster, so here I am. Now, give me the money.
I will have to detain you.
Fine, but I still get the reward, right?
Oh my God.
You can hope for a reduced sentence.
For handing yourself in.
It's not the reward I was hoping for, but I'll take it. It'll be good to get back to jail. Life as a free man can be tiring.
Take him away. Next, please.
Officer, I would like to report my son missing.
How old is he?
He's 24, but he's never been gone for so long without letting me know.
How long has it been?
Just over 2 days now.
We do not consider an adult missing within 72 hours.
Fucking hell. Oh,
please, I'm begging
24
you.
24
hours? Something's not right. You really need to find him.
What is his name and address?
George Elkins, 7706 Orchard Avenue.
Let me check. Your son was found dead 2 hours ago.
What? Oh, no.
Thanks for the help, Murphy.
That silly gun. Tanner went in to get his own reward. Fucking hell, man. It won't surprise me to some... Some people I've known in the past would do something fucking stupid like that. That what briefing room? What's wrong with my throat, man? Where's it wanting me to go? Shooting range. But what briefing room? It's a bit of a shithole, like, isn't it, this police station?
Murphy, I heard you're scheduled for calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready.
Step right up!
50 points is what OCP calls a passing grade. It'd 50. Be a problem to you.
I certainly shouldn't. Not 50. Oh. Fucking. Oh, come on!
Not even 50, huh?
What the fuck? I'm gonna have to zoom in, I think. I'm gonna have to zoom in, I think. I think that's what it's... Because I'm trying to do it freehand. Oh, come on! Oh, it just had to be reloading right at that fucking time, didn't it?
Maybe they really did mess you up.
Fuck me, man. Are you taking the piss? You see how long it takes to reload? Oh, come on, Merv, come on!
It's 50. Unless you want to try to break the record. Good job. I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to go. See you in the briefing room.
Whatever. Fucking about. Why is it stuttering? It is a bit poorly optimised, this, like. But then again, like I said, it's not made by a huge company, so they haven't done bad, really. Compared to friggin' Fort Collis.
So, what's on today's agenda?
The agenda... It's no secret that crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the torch heads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high-activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there!
You go ahead, partner. I need to write this report, and there's something else I need to do first.
Okay, Lewis. See you soon.
I'm gonna be over there. I'll send it up to you guys.
Riding along in my automobile, na-na-na-na-na-na-na. My baby beside me at the wheel, na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Wrong, Chief.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
Here we go. Do you want to leave the area? Yes, please. Come on. Come on, Robo. Wheel spins.
this city, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground. Believe me, just burn it all.
Hello there, little kitty. Hell. Well, I think it's supposed to be shell in it. Someone's nicked S. Delta City, that's what they're trying to build, isn't it? So they have to demolish all this to make way for new Delta City. So what's his objectives? That's it. Search for suit. What's this? Confiscate stolen items and crime evidence. Right. Is this the station? I think it is, isn't it? The station where that number one index ended up getting melted by frigging toxic waste.
My motor!
Wanted here filling his motorbike up when he saw Robocop. And he was like, he remembered him, didn't he? Went, it's impossible! We killed you! Looks like the station. But then again, pretty much hot petrol station looks the same, don't we? Yeah, I've got to say, it does look amazing. But again, it's on Epic, it's on, everything's maxed out, so you'd expect it to look good. But I am impressed. To say again that it's not a massive company, you know, that's released, that's developed it.
Coming up, is your air freshener secretly killing you? Find out at 11.
This is just full of bombs, isn't it?
Could you please keep the noise down? You're scaring off my customers.
Can't hear you. Music's too loud.
Good evening. Are those two men bothering you?
First they harass my customers, and then they threaten to burn down my shop. You need to do something about it, officer.
What do you want, cop? Can't we have a little bit of fun?
We did nothing wrong.
I can help him. There is also nothing wrong in breaking criminal rules.
Nothing wrong, you say? I say, nothing wrong in breaking criminal bones. Maybe we should all practice what we preach.
I don't know if there's something wrong with this beer or if listening to this silver nutcase made me sober up. Come on, man. Let's bail.
I didn't want to smash the radio up. Something to piss
Thanks,
off
officer.
Somewhere else. Fruity Loops. We all love Fruity Loops. I like chicken, I like liver. Yum, it's please deliver.
See you later, Grandpa. Punk you. Oh, what's going on here then? What do we have here then? Oh, that's that T-Rex out of the advert for that car that we're on about. I haven't seen one yet. I will show you when I see one, though. But it's like the top of the range car. That could be one over there, actually. I don't know. But yeah, the advert for it with this T-Rex, and its eyes popped out. It's like boing, you know, when it caught the car.
Hey, Robo, can you help me out here?
Be a man, Pig. Why make such a big deal?
How can I assist you, officer?
I'm trying to catch this one shifty dealer. This guy steals nuke from other pushers to sell it at half price. This dopehead buys from him but won't tell me his whereabouts.
I don't know any dealer.
You were carrying for three different pushers, so you either like to walk for miles to buy nuke, or you appreciate a discount.
Don't take it out on me, because the guy broke your nose.
As you can see, he doesn't want to cooperate.
Letting them steal means fewer drugs on the street.
Do not worry. According to my directives, there are several ways to convince him to cooperate.
I ain't gonna let it reprogram my brain. We can talk, but don't let it drill into my head, okay? The guy's name's Maurice, but I don't know where to find him. I always arrange a place over a payphone. I'll give you the number.
Let's hope it works. The dealer knows where the others hide their stash. We could collect nuke from the whole neighborhood if we get to him.
I will take care of it.
But you need to find a payphone first. Try near the supermarket. I think at least one of them hasn't been smashed by vandals yet.
See you soon, sugar tits. Straight. Didn't take him much, like, did it, for him to grass his dealer up? That's problem when you're dealing at street level. If it means getting locked up rattling, then they'll stick you in. No, I don't think... Is that it? Oh, it might be. No, that ain't it. It's one light. It looks a bit like that, though. But it's like the top end. I'll show you one when we see it. For yous that don't know. Phone booth is out of order. Fucking little scumbags. That used to do my head in back in the day, that. In back in the 90s, before mobile phones were out. We used to have to use pay phones and stuff. And fucking people just cutting wires on them and stuff. And then you think to yourself, okay, well, what if someone needed to phone an ambulance, you know? Like if it were one of their relations or something, after they'd cut a frigging wire on it. Or spitting on where buttons are and that you have people have to touch. Never understood all that sort of shit, man. Crime's one thing. If you're doing crime for money, then that's one thing, innit? You're doing it for money. But just to go around...
I always wanted to be a cop. I even applied to the academy, but it turns out that extensive criminal history and drug addiction prevent you getting in.
No shit, Sherlock. Oh.
I'm not letting this just in back at car.
So, something interesting in that barrel?
My sandwich fell in.
Ah, you've been dreaming of a hot meal, so here it is.
Wah, wah, wah. This phone booth is out of order. Well, hello there. Tattoo parlor.
Hey, I'll earn less if you hang around here.
Not if I'm buying. Unfortunately, my penis was not one of the things they saved.
Help! Help! This rascal was trying to steal my cart! Look what he's done!
Have I just wrecked your life savings? Tough shit, stinker!
Oh, after my this. Right.
Antisocial behavior towards a fellow citizen can be classified as a crime.
Issue a ticket. Yeah, I'm not letting him off. You're an asshole.
Lesson for the future. To save yourself the trouble. Clean up on the double.
You can't do it. I was only messing. I could have just picked it all up.
Hey, you tell him, robot man!
What a fucking joke!
What a fucking joke! Well, stop being a prick to fucking homeless people, then you horrible cunt.
Today, the whole nation mourns the loss of Mr. Pinky, host of America's most beloved children's show, Growing Up with Mr. Pinky. He was brutally murdered by a motorcycle gang in a Chicago brothel after a heroin smuggling gone wrong.
Magnavolt. Remember that as well, that one adverts on it for Car Thieves, where when they tried Nicky Carr, metal things came out of seat and locked him into the seat and then it electrocuted him. Magnavolt.
Magnavolt. The final word in auto security. No embarrassing alarm noise, no need to trouble the police. And it won't even run down your battery.
Magnavolt.
Right in front of a copper, yeah? Let's see what his attitude's like.
Littering is prohibited.
What was I supposed to do? I've missed the garbage collection and we had fish on Friday.
You have no idea how much it reeks.
He's not a knobhead.
I will not issue a ticket on this occasion, but remember that littering is like dumping negative emotions on others. It spoils the relationship.
Still better than a spoiled fish.
You get to decide who you want to give a warning to them that, and who you want to give a ticket to instantly, like that silly cunt. You hear his attitude in that we're starting with. Homeless guy. So he got a ticket straight away. Simple as.
I wasn't going to give him one. Although he shouldn't have been throwing rubbish in the water and river, but he didn't have an attitude really, did he?
My favorite TV star.
Thanks to you, Kurt's finally had a reason to watch something other than the fast food channel.
When it comes to cleaning criminal scum from the city, I am even better live. Can you tell me what happened here?
Nasty murder. The victim is a white female, mid-20s, identified as Casey Carmel. Had a history of petty crime and prostitution, but believe it or not, that's her real name.
Any leads?
The case is closed. OCP won't spend a single dime on the murder of a prostitute.
Cost optimization. Fancy name for we don't give a shit about poor people.
So if you were to look around the crime scene, you would potentially be exposing OCP to extra costs.
If you want to do that, be our guest.
Oh, I will.
Do you have any thoughts about that murder?
I'd bet the girl was killed somewhere else, and the body was only dumped here. And we got the tire tracks, drag marks. If we find a car that matches, we'll find our perp. Yeah, I guess the perp had his hands covered in some green-blue guacamole-ish goo. The body's covered in it.
Why does it always come back to food with you? Anyway, we need to do a proper analysis.
The best way to cut the costs of policing is to cut the criminals down.
Tell me about it. I didn't join the force to pick up dead bodies off the street.
Yeah, but what can we do?
Is that homeless man considered a suspect?
Nah, we know the guy. You can rule him out.
The guy's a loon, a mental patient. He thinks that aliens dumped the body here.
Talk to him if you want. Just prepare to hear a tall tale about green people.
I will look around. We must bring the murderer to justice.
Activate Robocop vision by pressing left trigger to highlight enemies in important actions in the environment. You can investigate these objects by using the ring on line.
Okay.
Oh,
I
don't
know if
I'm
gonna be able to bridge in it above us, I was going to say it. Let's check it out anyway. Whoa, fucking hell.
Somebody dumped her a few feet from here. The blood traces on the ground indicate she was dragged.
Is that... Been bashed over head with something. All the legs caved in. I'm one of the eyes.
Nasty wound. Looks like she was hit with a blunt object, possibly a hammer.
It's caved her skull in completely, hasn't it? On right, left hand side of her head. Ooh, a bit creepy crawlies going in it. Got a slash on her tits.
Her heels had to touch the ground when the body was dragged. That's this green-blue shit under her arm. No idea what it might be, but there is more of it around.
Yeah,
it probably belonged to our victim. Let's try to find other clues.
Poor Casey.
Custom extended wheelbase. Have you seen a vehicle like this around?
Nah. But that narrows it down significantly. Good catch, Robo.
Oh, I can help you find the guy who dumped the body here. I saw him, but you must accept the truth.
Tell me what you know.
It's as simple as it gets. Aliens did it.
Aliens?
I've been investigating them for years. They send rats to spy on me. They don't want me to show you this list. It's a list of aliens living in Detroit. All 37,617 of them. The murderer included.
Most likely a van with a custom extended wheelbase. Does your list contain any information on such a vehicle?
Jackpot! I've got a guy with a van that matches your description. I don't know his ID, but I know where you can find him. A film set near the courthouse. They're shooting a TV commercial and it's run by aliens, so it all makes sense. Casey must have discovered something there, and they got her. That must have been what's happened.
What is the purpose of your list?
It's my tool to spread the truth. I update it every month and add it to my newsletter. You should read it. It's free. You'll find out some stuff that you wouldn't see on TV.
Like what?
Take the moon landing, for example. Didn't happen.
Why?
Because the moon doesn't exist. First time hearing about it? That's why you need my newsletter.
The moon don't exist.
Why do you think that aliens run the set?
Who do you think runs the advertising business? They're stuffing commercials with subliminal messages. They use additional film frames with commands to make us obey. Don't you know what happens to those who watch TV?
Why do you think that aliens are involved?
I saw the guy who dumped the body here. I saw his skin. It was green and glowing like those toy dinosaurs that children play with, and years later develop serious diseases from.
I will verify your statement. Nevertheless, I recommend you consult a psychiatrist at the earliest possible time. Now, the set.
Because this is his living room then. Hey, suppose it's better than fuck all. He's got a roof over his head, hasn't he? Free, no rent. I'm sure he could get some electric off one of these lights here. Could easily wire, well I could anyway. Easily wire a wire into that, bring it down into here. You could have telly and everything. He could. Later, run, Jeremy.
Mike was driving and we heard what we thought was a blown tire, but it was just a gunshot.
Just a gunshot, yeah. You know, just a gunshot. No, no special.
And she takes off her top and says,
"Hey, this is a private conversation, pig."
Well, why did she say that? She took off her top and said, "Hey, this is a private conversation, pig." I needed to hear that from an old VW camper. No. They've gone shy all of a sudden.
Drew a gun, asked me for money. Only a moron steals from a beggar. That's what I said. But then he started shooting.
Down there, he's an asshole.
Alrighty then, thanks for that thrilling information. That's it, so there's no collect. So I've just come upon roof for him to tell me that that guy down there is an asshole. Well worth it.
When this old world starts getting me down,
Oh, is that them? Oh, fucking hell, I haven't seen one of them for years, man. The old trash cans with rubber lids. They were like tyre rubber. I think that's what it is, that they were made out of, like old recycled tyres or something. But yeah, I haven't seen one of them for a long, long time. I didn't even know they had them at all in America. Thought it were a British thing.
At least it ain't raining.
I just want to get that phone and then, or I might just finish it now because we're already past 2 hours now. I don't think there's any point in me starting any of them cases, is that because we've got to get to a working phone and we've got to go and check that film set out behind car.
If you feel lonely, you know where to find me, officer.
If I had a penis, we'd be going somewhere lovely. Unfortunately, though, I don't. Well. Alright, 50p. The whole frigging town is just homeless, aren't they? Or alkies, or prostitutes, or... So what's going to end up happening in the UK if we don't start getting some leadership that's got something about them? Right, I think, to be honest, we'll leave it there for this one. I don't want to start solving any cases that are out yet, because that's just going to take us way past the time. I think we've got pretty much about an idea of it now, aren't we? I know it controls now. We've got a bit of an idea what's going on with story. It is just a straight follow-up from the film so far, isn't it? It's obviously Murphy's still struggling with his machine and his biological side. Detroit's going to hell because Source EP again are just trying to flatten this old part of Detroit so they can build Delta City, basically. So crime rate's just gone through the roof because they're cutting corners as well, out that costs with frigging policing and that as well. Like that prostitute that got murdered, they just said don't even bother investigating it because she were a prostitute. So yeah, it's all going tits up, innit? But obviously the story will develop as we go along. As with any part one, it's just a case of getting to know a bit of story, isn't it? Bit of backstory of where we're at with it and stuff. Then, like I say, getting to know the controls and the whole thing with the points, you know, for upgrading him, his abilities and stuff like that. So yeah, the story will just get better and better and better as we go along now. Obviously, when we start part two tomorrow, we'll be straight on with solving these crimes here. And after I've solved them second, because they're secondary crimes, and after I've solved them, then we'll crack on with the main storyline, which is looking for that sub or whatever it's called. But yeah, guys, I don't know what your thoughts are on it, but you got to admit, it looks amazing, doesn't it? It looks absolutely amazing. This is more like what a game made in Unreal Engine 5 should look like. Now, when you think back to Fort Solace, how crap some of the textures in that were, and how, you know, the, like I said, the artifacting on the certain surfaces and stuff. That would be just because they'd cut certain things out, because it's made in the exact same engine as this is. You know what I mean? We're not getting any of it in this. And this also will have come out for consoles as well. So just shows you the door. Just have to check it out because it's coming out on consoles. Because this has
All they do is they just disable it in the console version, but leave it in for the PC gamers. So yeah, I'm really impressed with how it looks. I'm impressed with I'm impressed with voice acting and stuff like that, and obviously because it's done by the real actors that played in the films. The only bit I'm a bit, I won't say disappointed with, but that it's lacking in, I suppose, is the character models, you know, like the lip syncing and stuff. Obviously, again, it's not made by a AAA gaming developer. Obviously, I think they're just getting the point of trying to make a name for themselves at this point. But it just shows you how easy it is now to make a decent looking game in Unreal Engine 5. Now, it's all pretty much done for you. You've just got to, well, it's not done for you, but all the tools are there within this one engine, which were the biggest part of making a game originally, you know, for game developers, was making the engine with all the physics and the textures and everything like that, and the lighting and all the rest of it. That's all pretty much done now in Unreal Engine, so all you have to do is come up with a good story and then start creating the characters and all the maps and, you know, building it within that engine. So yeah, it just makes it easier for smaller companies like the guys that have made this to be able to produce a really good looking game. Which just helps, I think. It just gives us more of a variety instead of just only the big AAA games looking good and all the rest of them having to, you know, look crappier. So yeah, I'm impressed anyway. Like I said, the only thing that I'm not really as impressed with was the lip syncing on the characters. They don't really match up with what they're saying. I don't know if that's because it was originally made in Japanese or Chinese or whatever. So it's just not matching up with the English version, or if it's just because the lip syncing wasn't a priority, you know, when they made it and stuff. I don't know, because it is a big thing, is that it's quite expensive to get all the proper facial capture stuff done for, you know, like they do in films and stuff, where you have them white dots all over the bodies and the face and stuff to capture the movement for the CGI. It can be really expensive to do that, so for a smaller developer, they probably just drew it in themselves without actually doing the proper lip syncing. And that's why it doesn't look like they're really saying what they're saying. But that's a small detail, I can get around that, you know. It's not a deal breaker in that for me. But as a whole, it seems good. So we just need to get into the story of it now and find out what's going on. So yeah, guys, again, I hope you guys are enjoying it. I hope you like it so far. If you've got any comments or any feedback to give about the game yourself, or when you thought, you know, if you've got any thoughts about it, anything I've just said, or any thoughts of your own about the game, anything you think they could have done better, or that they've done well, or all like that, just feel free to put it in comments. As always, I always have a read through them if anybody comments, and I'll get back to you on that. But yeah, other than that, guys, thanks for joining me. And as always, if you want to support Immersion Gaming and support me on this journey to make a much better channel, basically, that's specifically for story-focused games, then as always, it's completely free to do. It's never going to cost you a penny. It's just as simple as taking a couple of seconds of your time out just to click a couple of buttons for me, and it'd be very, very, very much appreciated, guys, because that's what's needed if I'm going to be able to really start giving it me all, this channel, you know, and going all out with it. So yeah, guys, as always, the ways to do that is if you can click the like button, the thumbs up button underneath the video on both YouTube or Facebook, wherever you're watching it. Again, that helps with the algorithm on either side, and just means our video gets pushed out to more people. Also, if you want to click follow on the Immersion Gaming Facebook page, that helps the channel grow on Facebook, obviously, but it also will allow me to start doing things like live streaming and stuff like that again, because you need a certain amount of followers to do that on Facebook. But the only way really to support the Immersion Gaming channel and to make what's going to enable me to be able to do this full time and for you to become part of the community officially and be part of all the things that I'll be doing going ahead, like competitions and stuff like that. The only way to do that is to click the subscribe button on the Immersion Gaming YouTube channel. Again, it's completely free, just as simple as clicking a button, and all it does is it puts our channel into your favourites on YouTube. That's it. Doesn't send you any notifications or ever like try charging you or out like that. There's no charges or out involved. It simply puts our channel into your favourites on YouTube. But if you do want to be notified when I upload a new video, then if you click the bell icon next to the subscribe button, when you click subscribe, then click the bell icon as well. The bell icon means that you'll get a little notification on YouTube every time I upload a new video. But that's optional, you don't need to have that on. It's the subscribing that helps the channel grow. The bell icon really is just to keep you updated on my new releases, that's all, if that's what you want. But yeah guys, other than that, that's it. Did you know that's the way to help the channel grow? Other than that though, thank you very much for joining us guys, and hopefully you'll come and join us tomorrow for part two, when hopefully we'll start getting into the nitty gritty of the story and find out what's going on. So until then, take care of your sends, and I will speak to you all very soon. Bye.